Hello and welcome back to Alright Guns. Before we start, let me set the scene. So, we're going back to mid-December now, and I had a text message from my friend who works at Shooting Sports UK. He says, are you still interested in a Beretta 694? I says, potentially. What you got? He says, there's just come up available a ex-demo gun at the wholesalers. Are you interested? So, we had a bit of a backwards and forwards, and there was a bit of discount involved because it was an ex-demo. Bit of part X in my side, and we came to terms and agreed them. Placed the order, great. It turns up, trying to remember now, a couple of days before the December lockdown. I didn't get a chance to shoot it. So for the first month of lockdown, I practiced mounting it and got used to it, and that was brilliant. And then I just couldn't stand the sight of it anymore, so I put it in the cabinet, and that's where it stayed for another 2 months. Until today, because lockdown's over, we can go ahead and shoot it again. So been looking forward to this. Before we go any further, just want to thank the guys at Shooting Sports UK, you know, for their ongoing support of the channel. If you're in the market for a new rifle, shotgun, air rifle, or any accessories, give them a look. Links down in the description. So, part exchanged my 691 for this, which was a bit of a gamble because it was doing me really well. I was shooting really well with it, you know, no problem. So, you know, put it on the line, and I'm hoping this will, you know, give me a bit of a performance boost, or if nothing else, the wood's an awful lot nicer. Right, let's get on the bench and go see what it's about. While it's in the case, this case is really nice, and it's a step up from the normal blue molded plastic ones you normally get from Beretta. It's just a bit of a step up. So it comes with two combination locks, and as you can see, it's got a nice blue foam lining. This is the first time I've had a case for a shotgun where I've actually considered using this to transport it to and from the range rather than using a gun slip, and obviously rather than this going up in the loft and gathering dust. So really nice. It comes with a set of 5 chokes and a key, balancing system weights, a screwdriver to adjust the trigger, a bottle of oil, a wrench to remove the stock, and also the warranty and instructions. Also comes with a spare recoil pad. Now this is the 30-inch sporting version. You can get it with 32-inch barrels as well as in a trap configuration. Both of those versions as well you can get with a adjustable comb on the stock. There's also coming a TSK stock version and a Victoria model. They'll be coming out soon. Anyway, let's get it put together and have a look. Okay, so here we are all together. Just before we get to the features, I just wanted to show you the balance of this gun. Now there's one weight in the back, but that's all I've done. So if we balance it there, that balances perfectly around the hinge pin. So yeah, that's just with one weight in the back. So yeah, the gun balances really well. So starting at the back, we have Beretta's MicroCore system. It comes with a 23mm pad and an 18mm pad. You could also get 13mm, 28mm versions, and then you can get plastic spacers that fit in between, which you either go from 2mm up to half an inch, so you can really dial in the length of pull. The wood on this one is probably the nicest I've seen. It's a really good example, and I think it's getting close to a grade 4. But on all the models I've seen, there are, you know, all solid threes at least. Now the dimensions of the stock have changed from the normal
sporting dimensions found on the other 690 series. The drop is now available in the standard 3455 as well as a 3450. But more noticeably is the wider cone width. What that's done is made the whole thing feel a bit more chunky, and the extra radius there is meant to reduce rollover. So the new dimensions lead me into my only real issue with this gun, and that is the pad to wood fit. I don't know whether it's because they've changed the dimensions of the stock, but there's a definite lip all the way around the pad. And it's just, it's livable, but it's just not what you'd expect with a gun at this price point. It's laser checkered and pretty well done with a nice outline detail. The angle on the grip is a little more aggressive, a little bit more trap style, but that seems to be the way all sporters are going at the moment. And it's got a really nice palm swell, really big palm swell, so that helps to locate hand in place every time and be repeatable. They've also added these cutouts into the wood, which are supposed to aid visibility and give you a better picture on target. I'm not convinced, but you know, I'll hold judgment till we've shot it. The trigger is adjustable, and all you need to do is loosen the screw and it slides forward and backwards to give you a nice comfortable length from the hand. On the top lever, they've got rid of the rubber coating that you found on some of the other the 692 models, and they've replaced it with a nice swept back design, and I think it looks really nice. The safety and selectors have been slightly modified, not too much, but they are a new design. Nice and simple for the safety, and then for the barrel select, whichever is marked in red is the one that's going to fire first. I'm hoping with this design they've made it less likely to accidentally knock the selector, which I did find on my 691 would happen fairly regular. I think the action on this gun is fantastic. They've gone away from the normal round design that you find on almost all other Berettas and gone for this angular look, and I think it's a breath of fresh air really into the lineup. It's very simple, there's hardly any engraving at all, but what they have done is created a look with different finishes. So there's a mirror finish that runs around the edges and on the hinge pin, and then there's a satin finish over most of it, and then up top here there's an anti-glare finish. So it just adds another dimension to it. The only markings on there are Beretta and 694, and then a line, all of which are inlaid in blue, and then a similar thing on the bottom with the Beretta logo. The sporter is chambered in 3-inch and the trap is 2¾. These drawers here are interchangeable, so if they become worn you can stick some oversized ones in, just improving the life of the gun even further. The ejectors are fairly standard, and they've gone away from the ones that were found in the early 692s that you could turn off, and just gone for a more simpler design. It comes with a rounded forend, and this is a whole new design. Let's just take it off and have a look. Going away from the single piece iron found in the 691, this is now a two-piece iron. And it's just ever so slightly changed. There's less exposed metalwork, which I prefer. And some of the parts on here are interchangeable, so again, adding to the life of the gun. While we've got this off, you can also see these holes here, and that's for the balancing system. Although, I did find these were quite expensive, and if you can balance at the back of the gun, I think it's going to be much more cost effective if you do that. Barrels are Steelium Optima bore with forcing cones, which means they should dish out really, really good patterns. the backboard as well. The rib is tapered from 10mm down to 8mm with a single orange bead sight at the end, although I have seen plain white sights as well on these. The top and mid rib are both ventilated, and if you look at the end here, it's ventilated almost to the end on the mid rib, which was different to the 691, which stops about here, and I don't know if that's contributing to the better balance. It comes with a set of 5 colour coded chokes. They're Optima Bore HP. They come in cylinder, skeet, quarter, half and three quarter. I was a bit disappointed by this because I, when I shoot trap, like to shoot a three quarter and a full, so I'm going to have to get myself a full at some point. Right, let's go out and shoot it. The cartridges used today are Gameboar DTL Elite in 7.5 size shot, 28 gram load and plastic wads. Oh.
Done. So I'm sure you'll all be pleased to know I don't regret part exchanging the 691 for this. It's a fantastic gun and it's shot well. I'm really happy with it. It's important to note though, this is a different beast to the 691. It's a much more deliberate gun. I hope that makes sense. So you have to go through your shot routine. There's no chance for intuitive shooting with this. I found it very difficult on the stands just to wait for a bird and mount and shoot. You know, you have to get it shouldered, understand your position, just going through the basics of clay shooting, but really focusing on, and then it performs really well. So yeah, very different gun, but sort of why I bought it, you know, to focus and be a sporter, and I'm going to use something else for my game shooting. I'm going to be hanging on to this one for a good while. You know, I'm happy with it. It looks fantastic. The wood's brilliant. The metal works nice. Yeah, it's definitely going to be a keeper, unless someone wants to give me a phone call with about an ex-demo DT11 they want to do for off price. Then maybe. So that's it for today. Thanks very much for watching. Please like, subscribe, and follow the social media links in the description. And we'll see you next time.